It's officially released. OBS Studio version 27 is finally out, and with it comes a whole heap of new features for live streamers and content creators. In this video, we're going to be going through the 7 major new features, showing you exactly what they allow you to do and helping you set them up for your own live streams. As always, a huge thank you to the development team behind OBS Studio. We're getting this amazing software and all the updates completely for free, so a massive thanks to them. Let's see what they've been working on. Okay, so the first new feature in OBS Studio version 27 is probably the most requested feature over the past 2 or 3 years for the development team to work on, and that is the ability to undo actions. It's something that Streamlabs OBS has had for a couple of years now, and we finally now got it in OBS Studio as well. You can now undo and redo actions. So this one is pretty self-explanatory, really. If you make a mistake or change something that you didn't want to, you can now simply hit Control Z on your keyboard or come up to Edit and Undo, and there's also an option to redo things by using Shift Control Z. Thankfully, this doesn't just apply to moving or resizing sources around in the preview. You can basically undo any action that affects the preview. So adding or deleting sources, adding or deleting scenes, changing audio levels, adding or deleting filters. Essentially, any change that you can make that affects the preview, you can now undo. Some things aren't yet supported, like changing a setting inside of a filter, but over the past month or so that OBS has been testing its releases, they've been adding more and more areas where this undo feature works, so I wouldn't be surprised to see filter settings being undoable in the very near future. In my incredibly thorough testing of this feature, I tried to see how many steps backwards you could go with the undo feature, and I couldn't find a limit. But upon looking a little bit further, OBS did release a blog post stating that the limit was now 5,000 actions. So you're going to be covered no matter how many mistakes you make and how many times you need to use Control Z. This should help with those pixel perfect alignments when you're trying to get your overlays exactly right, or your webcam behind your overlays perfect, and you accidentally move a different layer. You can now just Control Z and go back to the state that you're in before, so should definitely help with alignment and setting up of your scenes and sources. Next up, we have source transitions. That's right, not scene transitions, but source transitions. In OBS version 27, you can now add a transition to each individual source for when it shows or when it hides. Simply right-click on any source, choose either show or hide transition, and select which transition you want to use. The options that you get for transitions are the exact same as scene transitions, so you can fade, swipe, slide, and luma wipe your sources in and out as you please. You can even now add stinger transitions just for individual sources, so I can't wait to see what some people decide to do with that. It's also worth noting that you can of course set up hotkeys in OBS Studio or use something like a Stream Deck or an app like Touch Portal to enable and disable individual sources, which will now show and hide with whatever transitions you've set them to. Even just a simple slide transition for showing or hiding your camera or alerts makes things look a lot more professional than the previous hard cut. If you have a Stream Deck or an app like Touch Portal, you can even set up some timed macros or multi-actions to do things like hiding your webcam with a transition, then changing scene with a stinger, and then revealing your webcam in the new scene with another transition. The third new feature is there is now support for NVIDIA's noise removal directly within OBS's filters. This feature does require you to install NVIDIA's audio effects SDK, and currently it only supports Windows, but if you have an RTX graphics card from NVIDIA, you no longer need to be running NVIDIA Broadcast or RTX Voice as an app. You can simply enable this filter through OBS. This is a super useful feature for those of you that are streaming in a non-ideal environment where you might have air conditioning or road noise or baby crying or a dog barking, because NVIDIA's noise removal has been trained specifically on noises like that to be able to remove them whilst maintaining a crisp level quality for your voice. To use it, first install the audio effects SDK, then open up the filters for your microphone, add a noise suppression filter, and then select NVIDIA noise removal. I'll do a quick demonstration over on the computer to highlight the differences between the noise suppression that you can now select in OBS Studio. So you have speaks, RN noise, and the new NVIDIA noise removal.
So the first thing we need to do is create a noisy environment. And I think we can all agree this wouldn't be a great listening experience for any of your viewers. So let's start by enabling speaks noise suppression. So that's enabled now, and this is how it sounds. Let's move to RN noise. So this is RN noise, which is designed to be better quality than speaks, but requires more CPU. And finally, let's move to NVIDIA noise removal. This is the new filter that OBS has just added in, designed to be the highest quality and not using any CPU, just the GPU.
So previously in OBS Studio, if you wanted to use a stinger transition, you would need to use a transparent video and have a moment in that video where the stinger is covering the whole frame of the video. And that's actually when you would be telling OBS to do the transition between the previous scene and the current scene. That point when your video is covering the whole frame, OBS can then transition in the background so it looks like a seamless transition between the two scenes with your stinger in between. Now though, what a track mat allows you to do is display parts of the previous and current scene at the same time, so you no longer need to have a point in your stinger transition where something is filling the whole frame. You're essentially using a second video with the colors white, black, and then shades of gray to tell OBS which scenes to display at what time. Now, creating a stinger transition with track mat support probably warrants its own dedicated tutorial video, but thankfully the team over at Nerd or Die have put together a pack of 5 different mat transitions that you can download for free and can easily be added into OBS Studio to start using this feature right away. These mat transitions also work in your video editing software, so you can make use of them. And for those of you that want a little more choice, there's a pack of 20 premium mat transitions available through the Nerd or Die store. I'll leave some links down in the description below to both the free and paid versions if you want to check them out. So to add a new track mat stinger transition, all you need to do is add a new transition, select stinger, and then locate the stinger video file, which should have the track mat either on the right side or below it. Then simply check the use a track mat option, choose the correct layout, and you should be good to go. You don't need to worry about the transition point anymore like you did with old stingers, because OBS is using that track mat to know exactly which scene to display at all times. So as you can see here, during our transition, we can see both our previous scene and our current scene at the same time, all thanks to a track mat. I know my previous stinger tutorial has been super popular with you guys, so if you want to learn the next steps about how to create your own custom track mat stingers, let me know down in the comments below and I'll prioritize that as a video for you. Okay, I think we're up to feature number 5 now. They've added a missing files dialog, similar to those that you see in editing programs like Premiere Pro, where you can locate the media that is missing from your current scene setup. So whenever you launch OBS Studio or swap to a different scene collection, this will notify you if any of the files that you're using can no longer be found, so you can then locate them. Whilst not being a huge feature, this is super useful, especially if you've ever gone through the pain of moving your streaming setup to a new PC, and then all of your assets, your stream overlays, your text labels, all those things that you rely on in OBS Studio are in different folders and you need to go and relink every single one individually. That no longer happens. You just need to relocate one of the files, and as long as you've kept the structure the same, OBS will do the rest of the work for you and locate all of the rest of the missing media. Feature number 6 is that they've added a new capture method for display capture, which allows you to capture displays from different GPUs. This is a really important update for those of you that are streaming from laptops, where you encounter several black screen bugs when trying to capture displays because of the multiple GPUs that a laptop might have. This now adds an option into the display capture method where it allows you to select which GPU you want to use for the capture. Hopefully this will also help reduce the number of people that give up on streaming when they first download OBS Studio because they're running a laptop and they can't even seem to capture a display properly. So it's definitely going to be easier for new users to go live. Finally, feature number 7 is that there have been a lot of updates across the board for non-Windows users. So browser docs, Twitch account linking, and built-in chat are now available for macOS and Linux users, as well as there being now native support for Wayland in Linux. One thing to bear in mind is that this update has been pushed out to probably millions of streamers now, and there probably are going to be some bugs and some hotfix updates in the next couple of weeks. So it's worth always checking that you're running the latest version of OBS Studio. You can always come up to the help menu and check for updates to make sure you're running the latest version. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you're going to get the most out of the latest version of OBS Studio now. If you have enjoyed the video, please do hit that thumbs up button. That really does help me out, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.
Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is create a noisy environment.
All right, quicker.
On the ball, yeah? Time is money.